One of the tragedies, I believe this to be true, the tragedies of our current times in our life. I was a college professor, 15 years full professor. And, you know, Abraham Maslow, the psychologist, talks about overprotecting people and disrespecting people by thinking that they need your protection all the time.
Mm.
And to watch the current movement in safe spaces and protecting kids from words, college kids, you know, it's tragic. Because in the absence of letting people experience life, what you're also preventing is the development of resilience.
Yeah.
And the development of resilience is the greatest gift, because life's hard. There's no way to protect people. I mean, this is from time immemorial. Suffering is the universality of the human condition. It's going to happen at some point. And if you don't have mechanisms to deal with hard times, you're going to be depressed and anxious, and your life is going to be sad.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I hear that your son failed and he asked to go practice, that's a tell. So if you were to have someone like you would ever call me and say, hey, can you help me with my parenting? I'd say, no, I can't improve upon that. It's like when Jordan Spieth called me, can you help me? No. Just keep doing what you're doing. Like you got it. And then he went and won by 10 shots that week and so forth. And so resilience matters. And like, it's the biological mandate. You know, when boxers get punched again and again and again, you know what happens? Their bones calcify and they get stronger. When people go blind, you know what happens? Their hearing gets better. When we're hot, we sweat. When we're cold, we get goosebumps. As human beings, we are designed to adapt. And when you overprotect people from developing the mechanisms that make them resilient, you're also protecting them from having belief in themselves. So whenever I have a golfer, or a market participant and things don't go well for them, what you'll often hear me say is, I'm sorry for what you're going through. I know it hurts.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't take this pain away from you even if I could. In other words, this is your cross to bear. This is formative. And what I also say is, because the brain tries to run away from pain. People escape into drugs, alcohol, and denial, and rationalization, blame. It's your fault. Like, no. You want to live at the tail end of the curve? Sit in your discomfort, like live in it. And Tiger Woods says, I refuse to give in to fear, real or imagined, or to be afraid of anyone or anything. And you've heard him say 1,000 times in interviews, eyeball to eyeball. He always uses the phrase eyeball to eyeball.
Really?
That's not just with people, it's with fear. Stare at the discomfort, live in it.
Mm.
Watch what emerges when you're having the honest conversation with yourself, and realize what Jocko Willink calls radical accountability.
Yep.
And so the values you preach and the generation that you're raising, psychologically, everything you put out there, I agree with, and apparently as a father as well. And this is what I'm trying to teach my PMs.
That's
all
cool.
The time.